this is Rick Kaselj from exercisesforinjuries.com. In this video, I wanted to go through the best stretch for the sartorius muscle. So the sartorius muscle, it's kind of the forgotten hip flexor muscle. And it's important to kind of target that muscle because it ends up affecting the knee and the hip. The sartorius muscle is involved in hip flexion, so bringing the knee up, and also involved in knee flexion, so it's kicking that knee out. It has secondary functions of hip external rotation, or moving that thigh out, and then also hip abduction, so bringing the thigh out to the side. But its primary functions are that hip flexion and knee flexion. So I'm going to get Orsini to kind of go through a stretch that ends up targeting that sartorius muscle. So you're lying down on your stomach. I'd recommend to kind of separate the feet a bit so you have a little bit of more movement to go through. You're going to bend the knee. Then you're going to drop the knee to the side, so I've internally rotated that thigh. I'm going to move the knee in, so I've adducted the hip, and that should end up hitting it. So we've ended up targeting that sartorius muscle. Now, if you don't feel anything, what you can end up doing is adding a little bit of hip extension. And I can do that by using like a foam roller. So I'm sliding the foam roller underneath Orsi's thigh, and she's gonna go through the same thing. Bending at the knee, dropping the heel out, bringing that thigh in, and then we've ended up targeting that sartorius muscle. And you're looking at feeling that stretch. It could be, I'm gonna move it out, there we go. It could end up being up in your hip area, or it can be down in your knee area. Now, what if you don't end up feeling a stretch, or what if you don't feel anything? Go back and make sure that you've done the exercise correctly. Looking at, you know, bending at that knee, dropping that heel out, so internally rotating that thigh, moving that thigh inwards or adducting that hip, and then adding some hip extension. Now, if you've made sure that you've, you know, tried progression one and progression two and your technique's perfect and you don't feel anything, there's a good chance that you don't need to stretch out your sartorius muscle. I mean, Orsi was kind of commenting that she didn't really feel anything with it, so it's probably a muscle that she doesn't need to stretch. But with myself, when I end up going through that, especially with that hip extension on that half foam roller, it really targets that sartorius for me. So give that a go. This is Rick Kaselj from exercisesforinjuries.com. Make sure to swing by exercisesforinjuries.com. Enter in your injury or pain. There's a good chance that I have a video, interview, or article that'll help you overcome your pain. Secondly, if you're watching this on YouTube, head up above, hit subscribe. What that'll do is every couple days you'll end up getting a video like this that I end up talking about overcoming injury and pain. Thirdly, head down below, hit like, and leave me a question or comment. So this is Rick Kaselj from exercisesforinjuries.com saying take care and bye-bye.